أقامت سفارة مملكة البحرين في واشنطن حفل استقبال بمناسبة احتفال مملكة البحرين بأعيادها الوطنية، والتي تتزامن مع مرور 50 عاما على قيام العلاقات الدبلوماسية بين مملكة البحرين والولايات المتحدة الأمريكية الصديقة،
وذلك بحضور عدد من الشخصيات البارزة من كبار المسؤولين في السلك العسكري والدبلوماسي والسياسي وممثلي مجلسي النواب والشيوخ الأمريكيين وعدد من أصدقاء المملكة. وخلال الحفل رفع سعادة الشيخ عبد الله بن راشد آل خليفة سفير مملكة البحرين لدى الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية أسماء آيات التهاني والتبريكات إلى مقام حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة عاهل البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه، وإلى صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد رئيس مجلس الوزراء حفظه الله، وإلى العائلة المالكة الكريمة وشعب مملكة البحرين الوفي بمناسبة احتفالات مملكة البحرين بأعيادها الوطنية إحياء لذكرى قيام الدولة البحرينية الحديثة في عهد المؤسس أحمد الفاتح كدولة عربية مسلمة عام 1783 ميلادية، وذكرى تولي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك المفدى حفظه الله ورعى مقاليد الحكم. وأكد سعادة الشيخ عبد الله بن راشد آل خليفة خلال الكلمة التي ألقاها أن العلاقات البحرينية الأمريكية علاقات تاريخية وطيدة تتسم بروح الشراكة والصداقة والتضامن، مشيرا إلى أهمية الاتفاقيات المبرمة بين البلدين من ضمنها اتفاقية التعاون الدفاعي المشترك واتفاقية التجارة الحرة. وشدد سعادة سفير مملكة البحرين في واشنطن على ضرورة الاستمرار في الاستفادة من إمكانيات البلدين في مختلف الأصعدة وشتى المجالات، مؤكدا أن ذكرى مرور 50 عاما على قيام العلاقات الدبلوماسية بين مملكة البحرين والولايات المتحدة الأمريكية تعكس عمق العلاقات بين البلدين الصديقين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, thank you, everyone, for joining us today for this intimate event. Tonight, we are commemorating the Kingdom of Bahrain's National Day, the anniversary of His Majesty the King's accession to the throne, and the 50th anniversary of our formal relations with the United States. But to fully appreciate this relationship, one needs to look back 130 years, when our two people first began working together. Over the century, this relationship has grown in size and nature. And as we all know, relationships can take many forms. But not every relationship develops into both a partnership and a friendship at the same time. However, due to the visionary leadership of His Majesty King Hamad, this relationship has done just that, by remaining unwaveringly respectful and mutually beneficial. Throughout the decades, both countries have sincerely prioritized one another's security, stability, and citizenry. Each country has taken action time and again in respect to the other's economy and prosperity. Tonight, we are here to recognize not a mere piece of paper that formalized this relationship, but rather to honor the people, the bold authors behind those initial agreements, the trailblazers that have brought us success after success, and those both here and in Bahrain empowering us to an even brighter future. With leaders like His Royal Highness Crown Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, that brighter future is not only in sight, but in reach. So we are here this evening to highlight those from the United States that are so grateful to have made Bahrain their home. We are also here to celebrate those of us from Bahrain that have had the good fortune to study or spend some time living here in the United States. One thing that has been proven repeatedly is the strength of our relationship. Our greatest achievements have been those conceived and nurtured together. While necessity plays and played somewhat of a hand, making it evident that the signing of a defense cooperation agreement 3 decades ago would benefit all humanity. Other benchmarks of our relationship were products of people wanting a better life and better opportunities for all. Both the bilateral investment treaty and the U.S.-Bahrain Free Trade Agreement were measures taken by two people so evidently desiring to do more together. And when Bahrain, increasingly guided by His Majesty the King, chose the right over the popular, we stepped forth as another foundational pillar on which to build a true and prosperous peace throughout the region with the Abraham Accords. Both Bahrain and the United States have taken turns demonstrating a shared desire to be an active participant in this relationship. With the launching of the annual strategic dialogue last year and the designation as a major security partner, our two nations prove to be standing fast at one another's side more firmly by the day. So please join me as we hear from others of the achievement, the dialogues, and opportunities that have touched so many lives throughout both our lands. Thank you for being here.